Now go to the infra damages. Puro flood control.
Parang
puro water, flood control, water, ano ito? Yung slope protection, no? Daming nasira. Bakit nasira yung slope protection? The slope protection exists precisely to avoid this kind of landslide. Paano nasira?
Public Works, please. Answer.
Director Tolentino po ng DTWH Region 3. So yung pong mga earth dike, dahil po sa lakas ng mga current ng Pampanga River, nagkaroon siya ng nasira po yung mga old existing dike natin. That's why sa lakas po ng volume na dumating sa Pampanga River, sa lahat po ng mga tributaries natin na na-damage po yung mga luma na, yung lumang-luma na ng mga 10 years ago.
So, okay, so anong plano? What do we do now?
Yeah,
don't tell me, aayusin na naman natin yung dike para masira ulit for the next one. Kailangan na may bagong plano.
Mayroon na po.
We need a new design.
Binabalidate na po namin, nakipag-usap po kay Secretary Manny Bonoan, ang sabi po niya is isasubmit namin sa NDRRMC for the funding purposes.
Puro to flood control, earth dike, slope protection, flood control, culvert, dike, shoulder, puro sa ano ito eh. This does not include, how about yung ating what we refer to as lifelines? Lifelines, yung mga kalsada, yung mga tulay.
Sir, yung hindi pa ho nakakaikot ng gusto yung public works po natin, sir, for assessment. Kaya for initial assessment pa lang ho to. Underwater pa rin ho yung...
Ba't di lumalabas yung tubig?
Eh,
yeah, of course.
I'm Congresswoman Ana York Bondong. Good morning po and thank you very much po for visiting our province. Malaking bagay po sa amin ito. I am the Congresswoman of the 4th District of Pampanga. I-clarify ko lang po, no, there are 198,000 affected families. I would like to let you know po, everybody in this room, 100,000 po na affected families ay nasa distrito ko. So 50% po of the families that are evacuated. At sa amin hindi na po in-evacuate kasi hindi na po kaya na evacuation center. Walong bayan po ang naging evacuation center mismo. They all piled po into the 4-story classroom building po or 2-story classroom building kasi po yung bahay nila hindi na po makayanan. So right now baka ho ano eh, the water is existing. So tama po yung tanong nyo, bakit po hindi makalabas yung tubig? And I would like to share, no, ang dami ko pong in-interview ng mga tao, this is the worst flood since 1972. I know it's shocking. I know it's nakakabigla. But since the tail dike was breached po in 2012, this is now the worst flood that has happened. Never before po have I seen four towns become a sea. Dagat na po, Makabebe, Masantol, Santo Tomas, San Simon, and Minalim. Ngayon po, the level of rainfall that fell was actually normal. Normal rain. Normal bagyo. Hindi po siya abnormally strong na bagyo. So upriver po, yung tubig na pumunta doon, okay lang. Pero sa downriver po, there was mysteriously a new source of water na bigla pong normally the baha sa baba takes days kasi bababa po yung tubig mula sa taas. Sa Santo Tomas po, 2 hours lang po at sa Palitan, Minalin, 2 hours lang po, may tubig na. So mysteriously, hindi po galing sa taas yung tubig. There was some new source. And the water was so overwhelming po. And it remains to be overwhelming today that the NLEX was already breached, which has never happened po since bata pa po ako. I have never seen sandbagging or pumping out of water sa NLEX. Ito po talaga ang nakadisrupt po, hindi lang po sa province of Pampanga, but the entire Luzon business, security, safety, ay napinsala po. So our one and only road going to the north, to Metro Manila ay hindi po nadaanan, and that is the NLEX. We have an alternative road, the MacArthur Highway, na dahil po sa problema, na-crash na po si MacArthur and nobody can pass there up to this day. Abot-kita po yung tubig last Sunday. So, I would like to say that this is probably the worst flood. Not in terms of agriculture po, yung sinabi niyo po, we are very grateful. Kaya lang po sa taas, where we mostly plant, which is ano, Candaba, San Luis, luckily, maliit lang po yung seedling. So wala pong masyadong nasirang rice. Though if you want to give help, okay lang po yun. But to be very honest po, it was not as devastating upstream. Yung downstream po, and today, we still have a lot of water. And kinatatakot ko po sa NLEX, baka po mag-last po ng weeks to months. And every time it rains, the same thing will happen. So sana po matulungan niyo po kami, and we are very willing to work with you po.
Yeah, let's first, I'm happy that former Secretary Babe Singson is here. Because siya talagang pinag-aaralan niya itong takbo ng daloy ng tubig. Siya ang gumagawa ng plano para sa ating flood control. Is there a particular reason why the water has collected and has taken so long to dissipate?
Good morning, Mr. President.
Good morning, everyone.
I was just explaining earlier this morning kay former President GMA at saka kay Governor Pineda that really the reason for this is that the whole water system or waterways in Bulacan, punong-puno na talaga. And therefore, the water that comes from Pampanga River, hindi makalabas. Because the natural drain of all of the uplands or upstream water, ang pupuntahan niyan Manila Bay.
Okay.
So since the waterways in Bulacan, because of the talaga excessive releases of water, from both Bustos at Ipo Dam, eh talagang punong-puno yung Bulacan Rivers, no? Hindi ho makalabas yung tubig galing Pampanga. So, again, as I was proposing, the solution here, the permanent solution, is water impounding upstream. The main reason, Mr. President, why Bulacan River is clogged, between Bustos and Ipo, no? Ang sinasabi sa amin ng NIA, because we've been meeting with NIA as well, si Administrator Gillian, 100 MLD or volume ng gagawin sa Bustos.
Yeah.
Pero sa Ipo, 700. Wow. May malaking volume na sumusubo between Bustos and Ipo. And this is from Bayabas River. So dapat mag-imbak na dun sa Bayabas, i-retain yung tubig doon, wag nang i-release habang bumabagyo. Para ganoon, medyo may carrying capacity po yung Bulacan. At makakalabas naman si Pampanga River water. Now, as far as Pampanga, the solution there is water impounding upstream San Antonio Swamp and Candaba Swamp. Para ganoon, during disturbances like this, yung excess water capacity of Pampanga, itatabi nyo muna dun sa water impounding both in San Antonio at Candaba Swamp, and release that when there is already carrying capacity on Pampanga River.
When you speak of impounding the rainwater, how big
may mga studies naman ho yan. We estimate Candaba might take 100, 200 hectares. Depende kung gaano kalalim ang huhukayin. Ganon din, mas maliit yung sa San Antonio Swamp. But ang problema kasi, from San Antonio, napakatarik po nung riverbeds. So dadalhin talaga niyan lahat ng putik, and the scouring that happens along the way,
sure,
eh talagang massive. Putik lahat.
If I may.
Yes.
I'm sorry, very, very sorry to interrupt. Secretary Babe Singson, I'm saying this po in front of the Mayor of Candaba at lahat po ng 4 distrito. Hindi po kami papayag sa impounding po sa Candaba Swamp. That is a wrong concept and we are not going to allow that. Diyan po sa Candaba, diyan po nag-umpisa Hukbalahap movement. If you want a security problem, sirain niyo po yung hanap buhay po ng lahat ng mga magsasaka sa Candaba. Mag-walk out po kami dito.
Ma'am, excuse me. The total Candaba Swamp is 2,000 hectares. Okay? Now, imbis na nababaha yung boom 2,000, like what's happening today?
Sir, Candaba Swamp and impounding is not the problem. There are many problems that includes, number one, subsidence for downriver. Number two,
I'm sorry?
Subsidence for sinking of
the
land.
But that's what precisely what he was explaining, is that hindi na nga hindi na napuno na. So, hindi natin, sa downriver sa inyo. Kaya nga hindi na bumababa yung tubig dahil puno na dito sa baba.
Naiimbuto po.
Kaya nga, pero hindi, this is not something that we're doing intentionally. It is something that has happened because napakalakas ng ulan.
Hindi po napakalakas ng ulan because the water in
Candaba. Napakalakas ng ulan doon sa taas,
normal.
Kaya bumaba yung tubig.
Yes po, but all the right. Water level was
let's,
not abnormally high.
Instead of arguing about it, what do you suggest?
Ito po ang suggestion ko. Number, I will go reasons, no? Sige na po, okay, excessive rain. But this is not the largest storm that ever hit Pampanga. Number two po, silting po. The rivers are silted down.
Let me focus you a little more clearly. What is your objection to the plan as Mr. Babe Singson has just
done? My objection to the plan, Candaba po, is this has been going on for a long
what
time.
What has been
gusto
going
po
on?
Nila yung tubig po sa Candaba gagamitin po sa kanilang waterworks. Ngayon po, Candaba is, ito lang ha, food security po ang importante sa Candaba. Hindi po natin pwedeng galawin. And number two, this is private land. Hindi po pwedeng mag-impounding lang po
okay,
ng tubig.
Okay, so what's the solution?
The solution po is to continue dredging, to check po on the flood control plan po of the Bulacan Airport to make sure makalabas po yung tubig.
Having supervised and administered all these dredging projects all around the country, they are temporary and exceedingly expensive.
Sir, meron po kaming Korean loan that's going to happen. So sana po matuloy
yun. Everywhere that we dredge, bumabalik din eh. Hukay ka ng hukay, tapos after 6 months, wala pang 6 months, puno na naman.
Ang meron po namin is dredging with slope protection. That is the subject of our Korean loan.
The siltation does not come from the slope. The siltation comes from upriver.
Totoo naman po yun.
Oh, it's upriver dahil nakalbo na yung mga bundok natin. So bumababa ang topsoil. And kahit na i-dredge mo, bababa pa rin yan. So that's the problem. You cannot continue to dredge. Number one, I will tell you. First, it is a very temporary solution. It lasts for, maganda na yung 4 to 6 months. Tapos magde-dredge ka ulit. Number two, napakamahal gawin. So, we cannot continue to do this as a solution na every season magde-dredge tayo. Malulugi ang buong gobyerno kung yan lang ang gagawin natin. We have to find a long-term solution. Now, the Candaba Swamp is not being proposed to be used as for one thing or another except as an impounding to keep the water up here na hindi bumababa. Hindi naman sisirain yung hanap buhay doon. Eh, swamp na nga eh. Dadagdagan lang ng tubig. So I know you feel strongly about it, but I don't quite understand why.
Ito lang po, no, sa Candaba Swamp po, this is very important. Food security po ang Candaba Swamp. The Candaba po, 3 plants 3 times a year. Pag linagyan niyo po yan ng tubig, dadagdag naman po ang rice import natin. In fact, the 4th District of Pampanga is the only rice-producing region right now in Pampanga. Pag i-impound nyo po yung tubig, wala na pong rice dito.
Ayaw sa amin. Sir President.
We ask the Mayor of Candaba po to let us.
I am the Mayor of Candaba. The project of the former secretary way back 2013. And those affected farmers, families, more than 9,000 in Candaba of that 2,000 hectares. Mr. President, wala silang pinropose sa amin that these 9,000 affected farmers will be given another job. So kaya tumayo yung mga kapampangan, yung mga taga-Candaba before, and we oppose this with Congressman M.P. Bongo, na ayaw namin sa Candaba.
Let me answer.